think Moss Book 2 is really, like, it is the next step. For Moss Book 1, we were really trying to figure out what would work in VR and what we thought players would like. We really had no idea. The first thing we wanted to do was to take players places they wanted to be. And that, in combination with trying to expand the world of Moss and going on a larger journey.
I have a lighthearted experience that Moss 1 was. We wanted to be a world that you can relax in and have fun in, feel challenged in, without ever feeling like you need to take the headset off and take a break or things are getting too much for you.
Our goal with VR wasn't just to create a thing that replicated what you could see if you played a game from Steam on your PC on a flat monitor. It was to take this technology that really puts you in that world and use that in a way that you couldn't get anywhere else.
I remember taking the headset off and having like almost like a mini existential crisis of like, wow, I can't believe, like, are these hands even real? And I feel like to be able to develop on this platform and give that similar experience to other players is kind of magical.
The difference with VR is that when you put on the headset, you're in a real world and everything feels normal scale to you, but also you're playing with this mouse that's 2 or 3 inches tall, and it's that that back and forth between like looking at her and seeing her as like a full-size character and then realizing, no, she's actually a tiny character in a big world.
Creating that emotional bond between the player and Quill, she does have subtleties in her emotions through these small vocalizations. Another way that I think is pretty unique about this game is Quill actually does ASL. Players might not understand and they'll just see them as gestures, but for people who do understand ASL, it's that extra layer of depth to the character that really helps build that bond.
You are playing a co-op game with Quill, and so you're both kind of getting to know each other the whole way through, and all those reactions that you both have. You look into a new area and you're kind of in awe and wowing at it. And you look at Quill to be like, what should I be doing next? And she's always there to be like, I think that that trigger up there might be our next best solution.
The climbing system in Moss Book 2 adds a new level of traversal and verticality to the game. This gives you the ability to sort of direct Quill towards the wall and climb up and on it and across, and she can span large gaps. She can use the walls to explore areas of Moss that previously she might not have been able to get to. Unreal State Machine has made it possible to control all those things in a way that is intuitive cross-discipline. Maybe our animators or our artists are less familiar with that kind of structure, and being able to visualize it in a way that is intuitive as Unreal makes it possible for me to collaborate with the animators and bring our shared vision to life.
Early on, we were deciding, like, what is a Moss 2 boss fight? What does it look like? How big is it? What's supposed to feel like? What tools are you going to use to overcome it? It was really experimental, and we kind of like tried a couple ideas, and eventually we just got the perfect set of mechanics and size and space, and it all kind of came together. And you can just watch all that play out in the room blueprint. The rooms also have sort of like sub blueprints. All the objects have blueprints. All the characters run off blueprint. Everything just kind of comes together, and you can just watch it all play out, kind of like a little orchestra.
I mean, blueprints are like key to everything. They're all throughout the project. An artist like me can go in and use a blueprint and understand what's going on. I think that really speaks to how well that whole system is implemented.
By having things blend between perspectives, that really adds to the sound of Moss. But that being said, there are certain areas in the game where having an abundant sense of life around you just doesn't fit the tonality, right? We've really leaned into, like, how can we create a really stark environment, drastically change, so you have a juxtaposition between really vibrant soundscapes as well as really dark and moody soundscapes as well. When a player spawns into a room, the system will dynamically generate 12 game objects in the world that statically live in the environment, and those will stay in the static game world. Imagine you're in a space, there's 2 speakers in front of you, 2 speakers behind you, and then you take those 4 speakers, you duplicate that, a level above that, and then a level below that. And effectively, you have these 12 locations. That really gives that sense of space directly around you.
I'm proud of every environment in the game. I think the team did an amazing job bringing just the amount of variety that we've gotten from the game. You're going like from, you know, the top of a snowy mountain all the way down into the depths of a fiery inferno and everything in between. And a lot wider variety than I think the first game, which I hope players can appreciate too.
Seeing Moss Book 2 come to a culmination and getting to work with all of the incredibly talented people here is a really big moment, and that I helped make this thing that's gonna touch people's lives everywhere, allow them to form that same kind of connection with Quill on an even deeper level than they did the first time around.